In this edition of Art Loft, we play it again as nostalgia takes center stage in Key Largo.
And he discovered Lauren Bacall and cast her opposite Bogart in To Have and Have Not. And you just can't invent it. You can't create it. It's either there or it isn't there, and it was there.
Object making art with a real world purpose.
This is how I think about art, but it's also how I think about social change. Like, I don't know if I can solve anyone else's problem but my own.
A music festival has everyone dancing in the streets.
These are local, and they perform regularly in their backyard.
And a poetic toast to the magic city.
To the daydreams, to the nightmares, to everything in between.
It's all ahead on this edition of Art Loft.
Funding for Art Loft was made possible by the John S. and James L. Knight Foundation, Newman's Own, giving all profit to charity and pursuing the common good for over 30 years, Alva H. and Wyline P. Chapman Foundation, and
in the Florida Keys and Key West, every night is a spectacular show. And every day is another masterpiece.
Hi, I'm Kaylin James, and from the private residence of Dan and Catherine Meixel, this is Art Loft. Key Largo was literally put on the map thanks to the 1948 film of the same name. So where else would you hold the first annual Humphrey Bogart Film Festival? The city pulled out all the stops in order to make this inaugural event a success, including meet and greets with Bogart's son, Stephen, and rides on the African Queen. If you couldn't get there this year, Art Loft was on the scene to show you what you missed.
First off, Humphrey Bogart had the good fortune to be in more than a handful of really great movies. You know, there's some wonderful actors who I love and old movie buffs care about, but they don't have the reputations nowadays because the films haven't held up or the films aren't as well known. Bogart is, I think, very contemporary for a lot of reasons, but he played anti-heroes. He didn't play pretty boys. He played men with inner conflicts and who questioned things. And that's a very fresh kind of idea that still appeals to people today. The character of Rick in Casablanca is anything but a conventional Hollywood hero.
What's the mother sign goes? That's the original.
My sister and I had been thinking about something like this for a number of years. Now was the right time, and Key Largo was jumped right in. They threw everything they had at it. They were behind it 100%.
Thanks, everybody. I'm just so happy to be here in Key Largo, and I'm so happy that all you guys are here, and you're so enthusiastic and so nice, and I know that you're going to enjoy the movie.
10 of my father's movies, 10 other movies, everything from Double Indemnity and Chinatown and Sunset Boulevard to Drive, which is the Ryan Gosling movie. It's a noir festival, and so all the movies are going to be based on that. A lot of different films, Treasure of the Sierra Madre, African Queen. There's a lot of stuff. There's a Casablanca ball. Jack Huston's going to be down here accepting the Maltese Falcon Award on behalf of his grandfather. Where else, you know? You're not going to go to Africa. We could do the African Queen. But it was perfect. It's a name that's well known. It's a name that people identify with. They made the song. And it was one of my mother and father's finest films. Huston, Eddie Robinson, and you know, it was the perfect place to do it.
The town is named Key Largo because of the movie. They actually changed the name to Key Largo because it resonated so strongly from the 1948 movie that Bogart was in. And secondly, the African Queen is docked here. The co-star, you could say, of his wonderful movie with Katharine Hepburn. So there are two very strong, very real links to Bogart sitting right in front of us.
Well, people ask me that. I think either Key Largo or To Have and Have Not, because without To Have and Have Not, I would not be here. So I kind of like that one as well.
Director Howard Hawks caught lightning in a bottle when he discovered Lauren Bacall and cast her opposite Bogart in To Have and Have Not. And you just can't invent it. You can't create it. It's either there or it isn't there, and it was there. Well, my favorite film of all is Casablanca, which I saw during a Bogart revival in the late 60s. At that time, he was sort of rediscovered by a new generation. And I was one of the lucky ones who got to see that film for the first time in a movie theater, not on TV, not on some form of home video, which came later, but in a theater on a big screen in the dark, the way it should be seen at its best.
I hope it happens. I hope it happens every year, and I hope everybody comes down and has a good time. That everybody's happy with how it comes out. That's really all you can ask for the first one.
If you'd like more information on the festival and information on next year's event, start by visiting fla-keys.com.
Well, part of Sweatstock is that it's also Record Store Day. There's all these exclusive vinyl releases that only independent stores that aren't chains can order.
The Borscht Film Festival is a quasi-yearly event held at iconic Miami venues, showcasing films created by emerging regional filmmakers. They tell Miami stories and forge the cinematic identity of the city. Over the next few weeks, Art Loft will present some films from past festivals, beginning appropriately with a toast. Filmmaker Marco Ramirez, a Miami native, gives us a nostalgic, layered, and semi-loving look at his city. Take a peek.
A toast. To the B-boys, to the ravers, to the checkout lady who'd be Playboy material if she ever waxed that upper lip, to the fat kid with a Darth Vader backpack, to his taller, skinnier cousin who walks 10 feet behind him on their way to school, to El Loquito who wrangles shopping carts like they were sheep, to priests who ride the Gravitron at church carnivals, to priests. To fly swatters, to hurricane warnings, to the bastard who scared the shit out of 6-year-old me and decided hurricanes have eyes, to wet dreams, Casio watches, to short lines in unemployment offices, to people who shoot guns in the air on New Year's Eve, to the birds that swoop down through the sunset and rest on tired telephone lines, to the first 100 who catch my eye every time, to the first 1,000 who remind me there's room for magic in the world, to the Noche Buena pig with prettier blue eyes than my first white girlfriend, to JP, who's still in jail for stealing a horse, to Manny, leaning over the hood of his Civic and throwing up Taco Bell, to the way he wiped his mouth and told me to man up and get in the car, to the Civic, to all Civics, to upward mobility, to the month I was a vegetarian, to the look on my mom's face, to the way my pop plopped my picadillo onto his plate, to Natasha with the bruises on her arms, to the band I hear she started in California, to the song I hope she wrote about her dad.
Thank you.
by visiting borschtcorp.com.
In some ways, pay Matthew and Yoko, I feel like I have to ask them every day, are you okay?
If you think Miami's heart only beats to salsa music, then think again. Indie music is alive in the 305 and it embraces the sweat. Sweatstock is the brainchild of longtime DJ and concert promoter Lauren Reskin, known to her friends and Sweat Record patrons as Lolo. One part record store day, one part music concert, and all street festival, Sweatstock cranks up the volume for Miami's local bands and vinyl files. Straight from the streets of Little Haiti, check this out.
We have our fourth Sweatstock Festival, which is an all-day free music event, block party festival with all sorts of local involvement, tons of vinyl, and food and fun and friends. Sweatstock is free and open to the public. The main outside area and street stage is all ages. People are welcome to bring, you know, kids and dogs. Well, part of Sweatstock is that it's also record store day. There's all these exclusive vinyl releases that only independent stores that aren't chains can order.
The thing that's so special about Record Store Day is that there's a lot of limited releases that you can't otherwise get, especially of like 7 inches and like collaborations between artists that you wouldn't expect to collaborate. And it's like a secret, you know, they don't release, like no one knows what was going to come out until this morning, so.
I mostly came here just to see the new bands. I'm really into the local scene and I'm hoping to see the best that it has to offer in Miami, because in places besides Churchill's, it doesn't really exist.
One of the things people are surprised about is that all the bands that they see playing on these stages are local and they perform regularly in their backyard.
A lot of other musicians come out to see us play, so it's like a really, that's something nice about the Miami like music community, is that you always know everybody who's out there. It feels good to play for your friends, you know? Whenever new people come to play, we always try and put on a good show, so, you know, we hope it is received well.
This party here, it's getting bigger every day. There's more bands emerging out. You know, that's why we're here.
Keeps the scene going here, because all too often you hear people complaining or wanting to go elsewhere to play, but you know, this is what keeps the Miami music scene alive, so I'm glad there's something like this that exists, you know, because it helps all of us musicians out.
They have great bands, a lot of fun, you know, you get to see a lot of local faces, local bands, and once again, you get to buy a bunch of records, you know. And you can definitely come with your kids, they have food outside, bands, and it's open, so you can have a good time and, you know, introduce your kids to something different, something new, you know. Music is always good.
We're really fortunate and had a bunch of really cool smaller local businesses step in and help out with the festival, and we're really thankful and grateful to have them as our sponsors.
This was a mural I did for Sweat, like I'm really good friends with them, and they gave me a wall. I have another one inside and they're awesome, they're like family. This is the third year I come. Like I said, I love these people. I support them everywhere I can.
You know, we've planned every detail, and then just watching it unfold is really great, and it lets us relax a bit more once it's actually on.
If you're looking for that rare indie LP or just curious about other Sweat events, Visit Sweat Records' website at sweatrecordsmiami.com. It is, right? It's like very serious hair. And vinyl file. I know what it is. It's falling. I was like, why can't I? Oh, I sound like a world-renowned star. Inaugural. I'll try it again. Inaugural. Okay. Inaugural.
Funding for Art Loft was made possible by the John S. and James L. Knight Foundation, Newman's Own, giving all profit to charity and pursuing the common good for over 30 years, Alva H. and Wyline P. Chapman Foundation, and
in the Florida Keys and Key West, every night is a spectacular show. And every day is another masterpiece.